Hello, and welcome back to Medmont's M700 tutorial videos. Now that you've watched the first videos in this series, you're an expert at visual field testing. But what about analyzing the results? In this tutorial, I'll discuss the view and the display tabs, various outputs for displaying data, and how to best visualize your perimetry results. To get started, select any pre-existing exam you have saved. In the far left column is a list of all of your patients. Double-clicking the patient name, pressing the right arrow key, or pressing the little triangle to the left of the name will expand the patient and show you all of the associated exams. If you're looking for a specific exam, you can press the Exams button at the bottom of this panel. Pressing the Patients button will bring you back to the patient view. You can search for a patient by typing your search criteria into the text box at the top of this panel, or set a filter by pressing on the Filter button at the bottom of the panel and defining your filter criteria. Now that you've selected the exam you want, you'll be presented with an image of the data in the main screen. The default view type is Image View. Press the View tab in the top left, and you're presented with options for how to view the data. Clicking the Details view provides you with a detailed rundown of how the test was conducted. Here, you find the strategy, information on outcomes, and data on the test reliability. You can also change the patient the test is assigned to, or update the date and time the test was taken. You can assign the test to a specific category, like baseline or pre-operation. And if you have the wrong practice or clinician selected when the test was taken, this is the place to update that information. Finally, you can add comments on a test. This is the window to go to if you're looking for a quick summary of the information found in the test. When you're ready to look at the test results in more detail, press the Image button. Notice before you press it that the tabs available to you depend on the view you're in. Once I press Image View, the Display and Annotate tabs appear. The Display tab is the main window for changing the way your results are displayed. In the top left of the toolbar are the Zoom, Pan, and Cursor sections. These are primarily used to examine topography in DV2000 exams, but you can play around with them to move the map around or find out more in the user manual. If you do move the map around, pressing the right mouse button gives you the option to change cursor types and reset the view to the default. Clicking a spot on the map displays the associated field data in the bottom right, the location on the field, and the threshold in decibels at that location. The panes section of the toolbar allows you to toggle on and off the right and bottom data panes. The right data pane shows all the test attributes, while the bottom pane gives a 2D cross-section of the data. You can change where the map is sectioned by choosing the select cursor and moving the blue line on the map. You can move it side to side by clicking anywhere in the center of the bar, and you can rotate it by pressing on the small circle at the end. Notice that if I drag the cross-section to intersect this scotoma, you see the dip in the visual field represented in the graph down here. In the Map Type section are your main options for changing the visual output of your data. The planar map is what we've been looking at up until this point. It can be displayed as a colored map or a shaded grayscale by clicking the Shaded Grayscale box in the Options section. This map can also be viewed in a three-dimensional perspective map. Again, your options for this view are color or shaded grayscale. The perspective view can be challenging to use, but patients may enjoy seeing their field in a three-dimensional view. For a more conventional way of viewing field data, the numeric and numeric grid maps are the most important. For Humphrey users, the numeric grid will be familiar. The M700 perimeter layout is set around a polar coordinate system, and the numeric view is how the data is collected. In the numeric grid layout, we simply convert this to the linear grid system used by Humphrey field analyzers, which maintains the quality of the data, but may make it easier to visualize for those used to the Humphrey layout. Numeric data is displayed by default in a non-linear scale. This is done to spread out the high density of macular points and to make viewing easier. However, if you prefer to see your maps with linear scaling, you can toggle it on and off using the non-linear scale box in Options. You can also choose to display numeric tick marks along the vertical and horizontal axis by pressing the numeric tick marks button. If we toggle between linear and non-linear scaling now, you can see that the scale adjusts with the data. Be aware that the non-linear scale option applies only to the numeric views. So far, we've been looking at this map using the levels display. This shows the data as the raw threshold values in decibels. If you press on the drop-down menu in the map type section, you're faced with a number of other display options. Let's start with age normal deviation. This compares the patient's threshold results to the age normal hill of vision for a person in the same age group. Age groups are split into 1 to 45 years old, 46 to 60, and 61 years plus. If viewed in numeric view, a single dot indicates that the threshold at that stimulus point was within 6 decibels of the age normal. A negative number is at least 6 decibels below the age normal and quantifies how depressed the point is relative to what should be expected for normal vision. This display is an important tool for viewing overall field loss as well as large defects. If you move down the drop-down list, you find the patient HOV deviation map type. With this map type, the software makes the best guess at what the patient's HOV would be in the absence of localized defects, and then plots defects against this HOV. Taking a simple curve through the patient's best vision, or a mean across the field, can produce an HOV that's more or less depressed than what it actually is. The software uses a robust statistical elimination technique to estimate the true underlying HOV without areas of localized defects. Stimulus points in the first 15 degrees that are within 4.5 decibels of the HOV and within 6.5 decibels past 15 degrees are displayed as a single dot. This view is important in identifying areas of localized field loss in a field that is depressed overall, as it makes it easier to identify these depressions. We now move into the probability maps. The next map view available is the age normal probability. This map is similar to the age normal deviation, but rather than give the raw difference in thresholds between the patient and the age normal, it rates their statistical significance. With the age normal deviation, unless the point has a huge deviation, it can be difficult to make solid conclusions about the depression. The age normal probability, you can conclusively decide if a point is significantly depressed. At the bottom left of this map, there's a legend showing how to identify points that have less than a 5% chance of occurring in a normal case, as well as 2.5%, 0.5%, and less than 0.1% chances. The second probability map is the patient HOV probability. This is similar to the age normal probability, but evaluates the significance in a point's deviation from the patient's hill of vision. The final map type is difference from baseline, which I'll save for the tutorial on disease progression analysis. A very important point to note is that all of these map types, other than those taken using threshold levels, provide the most data when viewed in numeric view. Because they are not displaying just levels, but have unique legends, the planar and perspective views do not fully show the intended display of the data. It's important to make sure you're viewing the correct maps with the correct displays as well. A test using the three-zone strategy, for example, will have the most useful data when viewed in a numeric display. When you look at this map, you'll see that points are broken down into three categories. But if it's viewed in a planar map, the software has to make estimates that detract from the simplified view seen in the numeric representation. There are two more methods for displaying your data that I'd like to quickly touch on. The first is the combination view. Browse at the View tab and select Combination from the Active View panel. This will display four different map types for the same exam. If you return to the Display tab, you can see that you can use all of the tools we discussed earlier for each map. Simply click on one of the maps and use the toolbar to change the display. The second extra display method is useful for viewing a patient's exam history. If you select the patient by name and return to the View tab, you'll find the thumbnail view. Selecting this displays every exam associated with that patient. The display options can be changed, but will apply to every exam of that type. You can also change the number of exams displayed by going to the Configure tab and pressing Preferences. Under the User Settings tab of the Preferences panel is the Review pane, which you can select to change the number of images displayed per row and per column in the thumbnail view. Okay, that's all for now. Thanks for watching and see you next time.